arrays. So each stream will have many different arrays. That is called as multiple allelism. Okay? What is allelism? These are the number of arrays. Okay, arrays, different arrays are there for the same gene. Multiple arrays means there is one gene called A and it is having many arrays of it. There are different factors like A, B, C, D, Y. So you can take the same example of RH blood group. There is a gene I and it is having multiple arrays like A, B, and O. One gene is having many arrays. So it is called as multiple alleles. Multiple allelism. One gene is having many alleles. It is called as multiple allelism. We will have only two alleles for each gene. If mono hybrid cross, di hybrid cross, we saw many examples, right? One gene will have only two alleles. But here we have many. And I can give many examples like this. Skin color in humans. Skin color in humans. Okay. And again in Drosophila you have. And also in plants you have. So there are many characters like this where you have multiple alleles. One best example is RH blood grouping is the best example. Okay. You understand what is multiple alleles? One gene having very different alleles. It's called multiple allelism. Clear? Next topic. Pleiotropy. Okay. So what is pleiotropy? It is just reverse of multiple allelism.
Only one allele.
So we have one gene having many alleles. A, B, O. That is multiple allelism. Okay. Okay, here what is, here we have one gene, it is showing many effects, that is showing many effects. Okay, I will take example of, example of humans I will take. Sickle cell anemia. What is sickle cell anemia? What is the shape of your RBC?
Biconcave.
In this disease, due to some gene mutation, susceptible to beta globin gene mutation, instead of your biconcave shape, all your RBC will turn to sickle shape.
This is a bad disease.
Okay. Due to the effect of beta globin mutation, beta globin gene mutation, the hemoglobin. Okay, hemoglobin is having four chains, two alpha chains and two beta chains. There is some mutation in the beta gene. Due to mutation in the beta gene, the biconcave shape is turned to sickle shape. And your oxygen transport, everything will be stopped here. Okay, your oxygen transport will be stopped to your body because of RBC damage. I told you it will show many effects. What is the main function of RBC? Oxygen transport. So, it will stop oxygen transport, it will cause liver damage, it will cause kidney damage, and you get blindness. Okay, you get blindness, you will get heart attack. Finally, multiple organ failure.
So these are different symptoms.
Multiple organ failure. Finally, it will lead to death. That is pleiotropy. Okay. That is mutation in a single gene is causing many effects. One gene mutation is causing many effects in the body. Pleiotropy. That is known as pleiotropy. Here is single gene, beta globin gene. That is causing sickle cell anemia. After that, not only sickle cell anemia, again we are considering to liver damage, kidney damage, blindness, heart attack, multiple organ failure, death. So one gene is showing many effects. One gene is showing many effects here. That is known as pleiotropy. One gene should show only one effect, right? According to the Mendel. One gene will have, either it's characterized, if you take tea as a character, it should show only tall or short. It is expressive. Okay, if you take R, it should show round character or wrinkled character. But what is this I mean? BWB gene is doing? It is a single gene. It should show only effect on the shape of the RBC. But why is it showing its effect on liver, kidney, eyes, heart? That is pleiotropy. One gene having its effect on many other organs or it is controlling many other pathways of the body. That is known as pleiotropy. Clear? It is not following the Mendelian law. According to Mendel, it should follow, if it is tree, it should fall into tall character or small character. If it is shape of the tree, it should show in a round or chimney. R should not show T should not show R. Now it is just mixing of all. Here, the beta globin gene is meant only for the shape of the RBC and oxygen transport. Why is it involving in all this liver damage, kidney damage, blindness? One gene is having multiple effects on the body. That is known as pleiotropy. Clear now? Clear everyone? Any doubt? Any confusions? Circle, any confusion? No, sorry? Clear what is pleiotropy? Clear? Okay, what is next topic? Quantitative inheritance. Okay, next we'll get combination like this. Okay, like that you will get 654321. Okay, I will write those. Okay, next will be KVPY. Capital is small. How many are there? Only 4, 5 are in here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 3 are. If you tell me, I am writing there. Okay, that is you will get 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 8, 2, 1 like its dominant traits. Okay, by that you compare it with, if all are dominant, then the color will be extremely dark. Extremely dark. Okay, and if only 7 are dominant, you will get very dark. If 6 are dominant, then you will get dark. 5 are dominant, you will get intermediate. If 4 are dominant, you will get light. Then very light
or white.
And extremely light or white. This is quantitative inheritance or continuous inheritance. So the genes are continuous here. The genes are continuous. Only the difference is only dominant, number of dominants it is counting. But all the genes are present in all the combinations, right? A, capital A is present, capital B is present, capital C, capital E. Here also we have all capitals. But due to the increasing or decreasing the number of dominant genes, there is a change in the color. So it is continuous. It is not discontinuous. We don't have, in all the genes we have one or the other dominant genes. Okay, it is continuous, it is not discontinuous. Okay, and here we have seen many different characters called extremely dark, very dark, dark, intermediate, light, very light and extremely light. That is due to number of dominant alleles. Based on the number of dominant alleles, these are mentioned. Okay, how the color is there. This is an example of qualitative inheritance and continuous inheritance, skin color in humans. Okay, in this way we have many other examples also. In Drosophila we can take examples. Okay, and we can take the hair color. We have different shades, right, in hair color also. From black to brown. Okay. Extremely white. Okay, I guess we have different colors. Those are the examples of quantitative inheritance or continuous inheritance. So these are the exceptions from Mendelian genetics. Are these five following any of the laws like law of dominance, law of segregation, independent assortment? Are they following the Mendelian laws? No, they are not following. So these are the exceptions from Mendelian laws. Okay, clear? These are the five exceptions from Mendelian laws. Who called all these things? What is the name of the scientist who rediscovered the laws of Mendel? Morgan, he did animal breeding. He used fruit fly as an example.
So it's not Morgan or Ibris?
Hugo de Ibris.
Who?
Hugo de Ibris. Hugo de Ibris and his co-workers who rediscovered the laws of Mendel.
Hugo what?
Hugo de Ibris. D.B. B.R.I.E.S. Genetics. What is the use of this incomplete dominance or alien genetics. Basically, what is the use of genetics? Is this genetics used in sex determination? Right? So the next topic is sex determination. So what do you mean by sex determination? When you take an individual, you have to say whether the individual is male or female. How do you tell it is male or female? How the individual is male or female? That is where the sex determination is useful. So, we have four different types of sex determination. What is there to know here? What is there to know? There are four different sex determination. Okay? XX, XY. Okay? XX, XO, ZW. Z, okay, these are the different sex determination. These two are known as male heterogamy. Male heterogamy. And these two are known as female heterogamy. Okay, here X is XY and X is XO. The male is having two different genes, XY and XO. So heterogamy, male heterogamy. Male is having two different genes, X or Y, here X or O. So it is known as male heterogamy. Male gamete is having heterogamy. Here female heterogamy. This is female. Female is having two different Z and W, Z and O. That is, it is called as female heterogamy. Clear? Why it is called as male heterogamy and female heterogamy? So these are for female, these genes are for male. In first step you can see, you have difference in the genes only in the male, X, Y, X, O. That is why it is called as male heterogamy. Change in the gamete, heterogamete. Okay, gamete stands for gametes, hetero means different. Here female heterogamy. In the females we have heterogametes. Okay, female heterogamy, in females we have heterogametes. Clear? Okay. Now, XX, XY type of sex determination is seen in humans. Okay. XX, XO is seen in grasshopper. Okay. ZW, ZZ is seen in birds. So these are the different examples for sex determination. XXXY in humans, XXXO in grasshopper, ZWZZ in birds, ZOZZ in moths. Okay? Clear? These are the four different types of sex determination. Now let us take an example of humans and do it. How it is used in sex determination. Now we are taking X, X, female and X, Y, male. I am indicating female with this and male with this symbols. Okay, these are the parents, male, female parent and male parent. Next is gamete. X gamete and both the same. Let me take 2 here and here X and Y. Now what are the four different combinations we are getting? This X, if it is crossing with this, we get X, X. This is crossing with this, we get X, Y. X, X, Y. Okay, if both gametes are X, X, female will obviously give X. Male can give either X or Y. If the male is giving the X chromosome, then what will be the condition of the individual? Either male or female?
Female.
Female. Here? Male. Here female. Here male. will determine the set using xx, xy. In number B. Clear?
Clear.
Everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And the same you can do it for xx, x more type?
No, yes.
In grasshoppers. One of you come here and do. Others come here.
Okay, and do. Okay.
Okay, now others will do it for better.